in the wild. Two wild javelinas stare at each other for dominance. This is the mating call.
We're right here.
There's movement. There's movement. There's closing in. He sees his prey.
I'm uncomfortable.
That's
so funny.
What's happening right now, Jimmy?
Dog sled.
Dog sled?
Dog sled, baby.
Uh-oh.
As you get stronger with that, do you have something that's about that same height so that you can get the instability but then continue working down like closer to the floor level?
Yeah, like I don't have anything, like I would need to elevate my back foot to be at like a plane level, you know what I'm saying? It's like, but for me it works good because like I can't even do it off the ground yet. Like it not that it doesn't hurt, but it's just I feel like I get a better stretch. But like try to do it without leaning all, like keep your foot like this. Don't toe dive your foot.
Keep your foot flat. Okay.
Try to keep your foot flat. Yeah, like that's now you're actually stretching your ankle, not just letting your foot like go into that board. Mm-hmm. But you have to really focus on trying to keep that heel down. Yeah, there you go.
This is my back, the knee that I caught, by the way.
The weaker one. Yeah.
Yeah. If you guys need to, we'll just do a remake. Fuck it. Get each other over. So this is what happened.
Good job, one more.
The YouTube comments are gonna be like, "You don't even deadlift like a black belt. Who gave you your black belt?"
Are you laughing? Deadlift test today. Hook grip. Just like last week with Josh, power position. Same thing with Pitt this week.
Correlation of the bar, so the bar pass stays under the center of gravity, but like the depression of my shoulders might cause me to look more rounded per se.
Yeah.
I'm just trying to get as vertical as possible so that the overall range of motion lessens a little bit, you know?
Yeah, I know Chris, he talks about that too.
Yeah.
forcing you to keep your arms long.
Yeah, that was a huge breakthrough for me. I used to finish up kind of up by my crotch.
Yeah.
So now I finish about halfway down my legs, and my pound for pound max went up drastically just fixing that, like taking off like 2-3 inches from the overall lift.
Wow.
So yeah, I enjoyed one. And the hook grip itself, I find, allows me to get a much better positioning.
Yeah.
Because it's like effectively straps.
Yeah.
You just gotta get through conditioning and thumb. But the way that I changed my hook grip recently, like, it's really not that painful. Because I put it right on the fatty part of my thumb, as opposed to a lot of times, and I started this way, a lot of times people put it right there and like grab it really hard. But then as the weight gets heavier, the bar rolls, and that's when it starts to dig into your thumb and even rip the skin.
Yeah.
So now I just put it like right on the fatty part there. To relax, and it even takes away like another like half inch from the range itself because my hands kind of relax.
A little longer.
Yeah, I call it trusting the hook.
Yeah.
So don't squeeze excessively hard, just trust that the friction of the hook itself will keep the bar.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
I need to practice that. Every time I've done hook grip, it's just a pain thing. It'll be in my hands, and then I'm almost feeling like insecure, like, oh, I'm not gonna have enough grip to hold it.
I felt the same way.
But I do just trust it.
If you see me go, like, for example, when I'm coming up to the bar, I just put my thumb like right underneath there, and then my middle finger wraps, and then everything else just comes in to further secure the position. But instead of like driving my hand down and squeezing overly hard,
yeah,
that's when I started ripping my thumb almost every other session, and then it takes like a week or two to heal, you know. So yeah, this way I like it much better. It allows my arms to stay longer too. The bar path is super straight up and down. And your vertical and everything, I agree that once you slim down again, it'll get even easier. But for what it is, I think very few people that are super wide are able to get that position that you are.
Yeah, it's tough, man. And like, I gained the weight so fast that it was almost shocking when I did come back to deadlift. Because even a few weeks ago, maybe like a month ago, I could not hold the bar into my shins. No matter how much I would go, I would still break it off the ground. I was about an inch away, but then right when I get to right here, I was able to engage my lats and then finish it. But then that all that pressure from off the ground would just go into my lower back, QL, glutes, like very bad, where I was just minimizing the amount of legs I was using to break it off the ground.
Back, like,
yeah,
I had no weight on my toes.
I can see
it. There's like no quad. Yeah. It's like all my backside. I'm like, I don't know, I'm just like, I just don't know my technique. So I just feel like, I don't know. I used to be able to use my quads way more. That was legit, like, all.
Oh. You see at the top, you go like that.
Yeah. I thought it was gonna fall.
Let's go, you hear me? Easy work.
Like, just the way I'm built. If you see, like, I'm just, like, not, like, other, like, for me, just because, like, for, like, when, like, in high school, I was always, like, front squat, so, like, I didn't do so much else, like, after high school, but I just feel strong and upright. Like, anything this way, I just feel, like, where you, like, kind of, like, weak a little bit. But just because it's sort of training, so, like, but still felt pretty good.
Yeah, that was fast, dude.
What you jump to?
I'll go shorter.
Or six?
I'll go six, yeah.
Let's go.
Hold it.
call it there for today.
Nice. I'll probably top it off with that.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll top it off. We went 525 last week, so 585 today. Probably save something a little bit heavier for later in the week at Barbell, so yeah, pretty happy with that one. Bellis feels so much different. I feel so much stronger with a brace going against a belt, but I think with a lot of the nasal breathing techniques to get a little bit more air in my diaphragm, that helped a lot, but don't want to take too big of jumps. So I'm pretty happy with the 585, especially given like popping my knee a couple weeks ago. So definitely very, very happy with that. Also, check out new Rare Breed attire. If you guys are interested, make sure to use my code JHOUSE10 at checkout on www.pippletorres.com for merchandise just like this and much, much more. We got sweatpants as well. And if you guys are in Santa Ana, California, make sure to come down to Rare Breed Live and check out Pipples' facility. Super, super dope private gym. Just that. We're excited at dogs.
Always wanted to lift heavy weights. It's not motivating. That's why when I would train at gyms when I was younger, I would always like go to hop around the gym and try to find the strongest person so I could be stronger than them. And like, that was just the motivation. That's why I love training with Big. That fool was always stronger than me. So like, I always wanted to be as strong as him, even though it's probably never gonna happen. He got like 200 pounds on me, but other than that, just that friendly competition, you know, I see him do it. I'm like, I wanna do that shit. Like, so I'm gonna do it. I haven't pulled 585 in a long time. So let's see if I still got it.
Good.
That shit felt heavy.
Once that shit passed your knees though, it flew up.
Yeah.
It was more breaking like, up the ground.
Shit, no belt too. I could just feel it in my like core and my back.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Do you find, maybe
with conventional, do you find that the belt makes a pretty big difference?
No, not at all.
Really? For me, for conventional, I feel like it makes a little bit more of a difference than maybe sumo, just because you're a little bit more over the bar.
On what?
For like deadlifting, like using a belt.
Yeah, like so when I pull conventional, like I've had to try use like I got hurt one time like US Open, I was pulling sumo and I just had to switch to conventional.
Oh really?
And I didn't even wear a belt because I can't breathe.
Okay.
You can't get a full breath of air when you're conventional. That's why people, but they'll conventional, most of them wear their belt higher or like up here because they could get their diaphragm more tighter. So sumo's opposite. I could keep my belt very tight because I'm like this, like. Even at the bottom, I'm more upright, so my lungs are like, my chest is not collapsed, but conventional, like, I saw how strong I'll get without belt this, and like, it didn't even help me put my belt on this, because it was a different position, like, the belt kind of like goes up in your belly a little bit, so I feel a carryover for sure when I do sumo and stuff, but I feel like you get strong on how you train. Like, I've like worked up to a 600 belt lift squat high bar, and I was like, if I can do that, I'll squat way more.
Yeah.
I put my belt on, like, and that I didn't even feel stronger just because I got so strong without it. Mm-hmm. So like it didn't even really add that much more. So I was like, fuck that, I'm always gonna train with the belt if I'm going heavy because it's like I already know my core and my back strong. So it's just like I'd rather be able to load more weight and just use it on top sets, and then when I do back down sets, just do like what's it called? No belt on my back down sets.
Nice, yeah. I mean that's still really good, Kevin. You never do that. Yeah, to me, it's even more impressive due to the fact that he's so used to sumo. You can tell, especially in the warm-ups, where his body kind of wants to put itself in sumo position. So he's kind of working against his own leverages for the conventional lift, but to still be able to pull 585 off at like 180.
My best is that CT Fletcher that pulled, it was 500, it was 585, it was 6 plates, or maybe 600, probably 585, and I did it for 5.
Oh, really? Conventional?
Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah, that was like the most I've ever done. I was like pumped.
That was
like
Iron Wars, wasn't it?
No, it was just some random. I remember they were filming something though. I think it was for like Generation Iron or something. They were just like filming something. And I did like, I pulled conventional. I don't know why. I was like in a prep. But yeah, that's the last time I remember. I was doing more conventional training with Chris. I thought like all you sumo lifters, like, you know, I talked to Steffi Cohen. Like conventional does not help sumo lifters at all. It makes your position way worse because conventional, you're just more right here. Sumo, you're more upright. So when I was like, I'm gonna just stick to conventional. Even Dan Green's program, Stephanie told her to do all that stuff. And she said it made her technique like a lot worse. And she got back, like, her deadlift went down a lot. And I remember seeing her like, man, she's only deadlifting 400. Like, that used to be easy for her. She was struggling. And same for me, when I came back from doing, I brought my conventional to 705. And then I was like, I wanna go back to sumo and feel strong. I felt like I didn't even know how to depth pull sumo no more because I was just in such a different position. So it's just like on what you want to be good at. Like, you have to just keep on going and you want to be strong at that. So that's pretty much it.
Yeah, smart.
What are you going to go do now? Are you going to do some shoulders or are you going to do like more?
I was probably going to do some
of the
new stuff.
Yeah, I mean, I'm going to do shoulders. You're going to do the new stuff.
Yeah.
All right, cool. Yeah, so me and Luke are going to hit some shoulders and then he's going to do some more knees over toes. So finish the workout, baby.
He tried to get me to agree to go skydiving.
Oh, really?
I was like, maybe not.
Everybody wants to go skydiving right now. Like, when people go skydiving, they're always like, this one guy I know, he like races a lot of cars. He's like, I have homies that can go 180 in a 45 mile per hour zone, but won't fucking skydive. That's different.
Yeah, that's what I would think too.
Second, I hit 2/3, I don't go skydiving.
Really?
But,
damn.
I just always been too heavy, so.
Is there an actual weight limit for it?
I didn't mean that. They say you can pay extra. You got two
knees. That's a genuine question. So one little trick I use to help keep the bar on my shoulders, especially if you can't properly do the front rack position, is a lot of times you see people either grab it or they put their hands over the top. I actually put the tips of my fingers into the bar and just lightly, not even press it into my neck, but just make sure that the bar itself doesn't roll forward. And it helps me with my positioning a lot. Generally, when people fail on a front squat, it's because they're not loading their quads properly. Or the bar just rolls forward because they're not doing a good job keeping their elbows high. Or just the grip itself is weak.
Open, but we came over here. Jimmy came down from AZ. He had a deadlift over here, and I don't pull conventional, so I was like, you know what, let me just mix it up. My knee's kind of bothering me when I pull sumo, so I worked up to a 585 just like him. Felt heavy. He moved a lot easier than me, but yeah, man. How's your knee feeling? I know they haven't seen you since.
Yeah,
that's your knee.
So I was in the last video where I caught my knee. It's about 97% right now. We've just been focusing on knees over toes movement. A lot of the stuff that you see Pitbull do is the stuff that I do in my recovery. And luckily today was good enough to pull 6 plates. So the next time we get together will be in Arizona, August 13th.
Yeah, man, I'm gonna go over there. We got the Culture Fit Expo. So hopefully next time we go over there, we can get some more running. I wanna do some jiu-jitsu stuff, man.
Yeah,
I'll get my purple belt. But yeah, man, hope you guys like the video. See you guys later.
Deuces.
Oh yeah.
The perfect.